Hello, hello, hello everyone. It's me again, your stitchy friend from the Philippines. This is James the Peach, teacher for another Flushy video update. This video is entitled Flush Tube Number 46, Fancy Lady, February Part 1. How is everyone? What's up everyone? I hope you are doing fine. If you are new here or if you are watching for the first time, this video is all about cross-stitching or this channel. And if you are into cross-stitching, you might as well click that subscribe button and watch my previous videos. And if you are a new subscriber, thank you and welcome to my channel. I hope you have watched the videos that I've posted for the past weeks or 3 years. And of course, how will I forget my regular subscribers or my returning viewers or my regular viewers? Hello once again, mabuhay, and I hope you will enjoy the whips that I will be sharing on this video. Last week I had uploaded a video. It was a flush tube extra and shows about the trip that I had together with my family and friends of my aunt in Hanoi, Vietnam. It was an unexpected trip because I was not supposed to join, but it was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity where I can go outside the country and have that trip that was on February 3 up to February 8. It was an unforgettable experience, and with that opportunity I just grabbed it. It was an unforgettable experience and I really enjoyed the trip, especially the scenic spots that we had visited. So if you haven't watched that video, so I'll just put it in my description box, the link. And also, if you wanted to watch my whip parade, I will also put down the link on mine on the description box. So for this video, I'll be showing to you 7 whips or projects that I have worked on before and after the trip, and also one during the trip. And out of that 7, I have a new start, and I decided to UFO something in place of that new start. So let us now begin with my first Fancy Lady. By the way, the hashtag Fancy Lady February, I've used this one from, I borrowed this one from DM's Crafty Vortex and her friend Anna. They had this hashtag last year in February, and I joined it last year, and then I will continue using this hashtag this month of February. So this is part 1. So any Fancy Lady that you are working on or you need to start, so you can use this hashtag. And the first one is from Mirabilia, and this is Spring Queen. This is now the progress of Spring Queen. So again, I didn't iron her, I just stored it in the plastic bag. So this is so far the progress of Spring Queen. So I added this part. So I think I've worked on for 3 days on this one. So that's the progress so far for the Spring Queen. So I will still be continuing to stitch this one next week And you will be seeing this one on my next flagship update in 3 weeks, I guess 3 weeks. So this is Spring Queen. Next fancy lady is another from Mirabilia, and this is my oldest Mirabilia whip, and this is the Winter Queen. So far, my progress of the Winter Queen, still not iron, but so I was working down here, this one, and then I changed my direction stitching on this one. I hope you can see the progress. So still I will be including this one of the whips that I will be stitching next in the next weeks. So this is so far the progress of my Winter Queen. The next whip that I will be showing is from Bella Filipina, and this is Nereid Galatea. So aside from the Fancy Lady February Sal, I am also using another hashtag, which is Bella Filipina Friday, which we agreed to use together with Miss Grace Slow Stitcher from Instagram, and we decided to use this hashtag every Friday, and we stitch Bella Filipina, and I think Burn Stitches also use this hashtag or stitching a Bella Filipina every Friday. So this is my first Bella Filipina for the month of February that I've stitched. So far, this is my progress of Nereid Galatea. So I am almost on her body. So I really love the colors that were used, and I think it's like a 3D with the use of the color. It's like it looks like on a 3D format. So still, this is one of my Bella Filipina that I wanted to finish this year, Bella Filipina whip, and you will still be seeing this one on my next update. So again, if you are stitching, or if you have whips, or if you have a Bella Filipina project or whip, maybe you can join us every Friday and use the hashtag Bella Filipina Friday. It would be amazing, and it would be what you call this, enjoyable thing that we are stitching the Bella Filipina or Bella Filipina whips every Friday. Next is another Bella Filipino. Next is not a fancy lady, but this one this whip is from Alfar's Embroidery, and this is the Black Vintage Sampler. I just had a small update of this one, for specifically this part. So I brought this one on my trip to Hanoi and I just stitched it once during our free time in the evening, but I had trouble sleeping there, so that's the only progress that I had on this one. Black vintage sampler from Alphorus Embroidery. Next, let's go back to the Fancy Lady, and this time I am stitching another Bella Filipina. And this is Queen Sari. Stitched this one last Friday, and so far this is my progress of Queen Sari. So I finished this one, this part, and then I also finished this part here. Look at the colors. I really, really love the color from yellow to purple. Look at her. Okay, so that's Queen Sari from Bella Filipina. Another whip. This is my new start, and this is again from Bella Filipina, and this is Fairy Iridescence. Yes, Iridescence. And so far the progress of this one, I stitched this one on a 14 count Aida fabric that I had. Dyed, and so far this is my progress. I started at the bottom of her dress since I don't have yet her the beads and the special threads. So far this is my progress of her. I think I started this one last Friday. Queen Sari, I stitched that one last week. So this is the Bella Filipina Friday number 3 and Fancy Lady February number 5. That's Fairy Iridescence. Last but not the least, this is not a Fancy Lady. This is from Alphorus Embroidery, and it's one of my whips that I wanted to finish early. And this is the Vintage Kitchen. Stitched this one this day, Sunday, and so far I managed to finish this cabinet and add this beautiful motif of roses and also some kitchen tools here. So I'll be doing this part, this furniture, and I think I'm gonna finish this one this month or in the month of March. I wanted to finish, so I only used two colors for this one, and this is 18 count Ina. So far this is my progress of Vintage Kitchen. kitchen. So those are my whips. So my plans for the next 3 weeks, I will still be stitching fancy ladies for 2 weeks, and then probably I'll be inserting some of my full coverage and other alfars embroidery, but my focus pieces are the vintage kitchen, my winter queen, my spring queen, and Nereid Galatea. So four of these whips I will still be stitching this for the next 3 weeks, and let's see what are the other whips that I will be working on. I'll be posting some of it on my Instagram account, and if you want to follow me, so James the Page Teacher, and I also have my TikTok account, James the Page Teacher, and also my Facebook page. So I think that would be all for this video. I wanted to make it short because it's evening here and I still need to edit, and it will take me 2 to 3 hours, and I need to sleep early and sleep early at night, and then wake up early for my work. So thank you very much for watching, and see you on my next Flush Tube update, and happy stitching everyone. Bye bye.